Haitian Prime Minister Ariel Henry has survived an assassination attack. Multiple people were wounded in the assault. At least one person was killed. It comes after a local gang had threatened that they were going to assassinate Henry. The members of the gang, there have now been arrest warrants issued. We'll talk more about this tomorrow. Get somebody with expertise in Haiti on. But just a little bit of background for people. And Robby, tell me what you think of this entire unfolding situation. So previously, as viewers of this show know, and anybody who's been following this knows, President Jovenel Moïse was assassinated.
Right.
A prosecutor who was assigned to look into this case, investigator, recommended charges against Ariel Henry.
Right, the Prime Minister. Yeah.
Who the United States is backing.
Right.
The United States, and after the prosecutor leveled these charges and said that that Henry was in touch with somebody suspected of participating in the assassination, you know, twice within the proximity of the assassination, which was in the middle of the night. After that, U.S. stuck with Ariel Henry, and the Ariel Henry fired the prosecutor and has since consolidated power. But consolidating power in a completely failed state is difficult. You know, gangs are the ones that are truly consolidating power and are transforming.
Bandits and terrorists. That's what
he called them. Bandits and terrorists.
Bandits and terrorists.
Right. So they're transforming from traditional street gangs that are just involved in criminal activity into government-like actors. You know, there's kind of a libertarian philosophy, right, around that. What is a government? A government is kind of
a monopoly on violence. Yes. You've eliminated all the other gangs and the only gang left is you, then you're a government.
Then you're the government. And because any other legitimate and illegitimate actors are being pushed out of the scene, in a lot of these neighborhoods and regions, you know, gangs are becoming the governing structure. And so to have it be a gang-related assassination attempt doesn't necessarily mean it's just a criminal situation. Like a lot of these gangs are now political in nature. Some of them have now adopted kind of revolutionary political goals that they've kind of become awakened and said, look, if anybody's going to save this island, maybe it has to be us. Nobody else is, you know, we can't leave it to Bill Gates and Bill Clinton. So that's where we are. Henry fled and survived, and presumably still has the strong backing of the United States. And there has been, as far as I know, there's been no serious progress made in the investigation into the previous assassination of Jovenel Moïse.
Right. So I'm reading from the Washington Post, where they say that. I'm sorry, this is our former, I lost my place here, the envoy,
yes.
Who's quit and become a critic, and he's saying this was fake. He resigned as U.S. Special Envoy to Haiti in September, has been a critic of Biden administration policy toward Haiti, said in a tweet that only Henry could try to spin the story this way, adding that it was a fake assassination attempt on a fake prime minister.
That also sounds probably more plausible.
Right.
Than an actual assassination attempt. Right, and so there were...
Because this was at a mass,
right.
And there's just gun... So during the mass, the gunfire never stopped. Bullets coming in all direction, hitting poles near government officials as they exited the service, but not actually firing at him, I guess.
Right.
So that does sound fake.
Although at least one person died.
Right.
But, you know, it wouldn't put it past somebody to kill someone in this fake setup. So, right, the idea
so
would be...
So it's chaos. We have no idea
on. The idea would be that one way to, you know, consolidate some public support is to survive an assassination attempt. And also...
False flag.
And also it creates an opportunity for you then to crack down on your opposition and to arrogate more power to yourself. Like the Kornilov affair during the Russian Revolution, for instance.
I don't know what that is.
It was a sort of... right-wing effort to overthrow the provisional socialist government, but it seems like a comedy of miscommunication that was then also kind of trumped up by the left to justify then kind of cracking down on the right. Now, there was probably, they were going to try it anyway, at some point, and Kornilov probably had some intentions. But the Kornilov affair was the kind of the thing that allowed the Bolsheviks to eventually take power. And so people have said, you know what, that whole thing was made up anyway. Mm. Though it wasn't entirely made up. So oftentimes there's a little, it's a lot grayer than it appears.
Well, it sounds very gray in this situation. Obviously, we want to get a guest on to talk about it more expertly. We're just reacting to the news that we saw as we were doing the show
today. And we'll have that for you tomorrow. And we'll have more Rising right after this.